So welcome back to the Omni Calculator channel, and today we're going to talk about our eDPI calculator. We're going to take 90 seconds to tell you what it does, how to use it, why would you use it, and show you a small example of using it. So without further ado, let's get to it. So we have four questions to answer, a calculator to showcase, and 90 seconds on the clock starting now. So first question is, what does this calculator do? And it helps you calculate the eDPI of your gaming system, which means that it gives you a number that relates how much mouse movement in the real world relates to how much in-game movement of typically the camera. So to use this calculator, you need two values. First one is the hardware DPI of your mouse, and that's generally what you configure with a button in the mouse, and it's the sensitivity of that mouse. Typically it would be like 400, 800, 1600, depends on the model you have. And the second number you need is the in-game sensitivity, and that's what you configure in the settings of the game, and it's typically given either as a decimal number or as a percentage. The question that you might have is, why would you want this number? Why is it important? And the reality of it is that as long as this number is the same, it doesn't matter which mouse you're using, which actual computer or monitor, the game will feel the same. So if I play at home with 800 DPI on my mouse and 0.35 sensitivity, when I go to my friend's house and he's playing at 2400 DPI, I can change the in-game sensitivity without messing with the mouse or having to bring my own, and the game will feel the same. It would feel as if I'm playing home, and I will be able to play as good as or as bad as I would do in the comfort of my own home. And that's some time to spare. Awesome. That is actually super cool for the first time. So we managed to make it in 90 seconds, but if that's not enough for you and you want a more in-depth look at the science behind these numbers, all of our calculators have a deep dive text accompanying them. So go check it out. The link is in the video description. And before you go, comment, like, all of those kind of things, but also I want to hear your suggestions for future videos or future calculators. We love creating new stuff. So until then, I'll leave you with a video where we explore another calculator and a video where we show why slow electrons create fast electricity. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.